been done and what the other people are taking over.
Investigators learned that the supervisor of the midnight shift decided there wasn't enough time to do both sides.
Guys, forget the left side for tonight. Let's get this plane out of here.
So the guys spent most of the shift.
A few hours later, mechanics finished changing the DIC. Install the right side leading edge.
So mechanics didn't do any work at all on the left side?
No, we didn't doubt it.
After having changed just the right de-ice boot, airplane 701 is rolled out to the gate for the first flight of the day. Leading edge rips off the tail, causing the aircraft to plummet almost 12,000 feet to the ground. Back in Washington, NTSB investigators try to piece together the information they've gathered so far.
And the pod. Individual mechanics, the supervisors, in general, I thought we had good cooperation. They did describe what they were doing. I think they were credible. I believe they were trying to help.
Where was Anderson? He was helping.
Yeah, no, wait,
we're going to get both
at the same time, Linda had the second shift.
Investigators are almost certain that the screws were removed from the top of the left side leading edge and never replaced. But maintenance workers insist they only worked on the right side. Investigators are puzzled.
So the second shift started the job. These guys, they started on the right side. The inspector, he helped them.
It's always dangerous when you change from one shift to another shift, and that's why there are very strict procedures about that. They were bypassing. The inspector jumped in to get this airplane moving. That was all disturbing.
Did he ever say what he did up there?
That's what I said.
How did the mechanics remove the DS boots? What does that mean?
To try to determine precisely what work Inspector Henderson performed in the room of trouble.
Help mechanics remove DIS boots. It's a very simple statement. It's not specific as to what was taken off the aircraft.